Hello, everyone, and welcome to VMwareLab.org. My name is Mahar Al-Asfar. I'm a Cloud Management Staff SE with VMware. In this video, we will be covering the migration of an existing instance of vRealize Suite Lifecycle Manager 2.x to the new vRealize Suite Lifecycle Manager 8.0. And that's including the import of an existing instance of VMware Identity Manager 3.3.0. The migration workflow will start by us downloading and starting the vRealize Easy Installer and selecting the migration option. We will be providing the new LCM deployment inputs, followed by providing the existing LCM instance inputs that we're migrating from. We will also be selecting to import an existing instance of VIDM and finally submitting the migration request. Once the process completes, we will log in into LCM to verify the migration tasks. We will look at the data center and the vCenter endpoints that are configured. We will also verify that both VIDM and the existing vRealize environment have migrated successfully. Now, as for the requirements, we will need a new host name, IP address, and a DNS record for the new LCM appliance that the Easy Installer will be creating. We need to make sure that the password for the SSH user on the existing VIDM appliance is not expired. Enable root access for SSH on the existing VIDM, and that's by following the VMware Knowledge Base article 2047626. We also need to download the install and upgrade binaries for the new vRealize Suite 2019. At the end of the video, we will make sure that we have enough storage on the new LCM 8.0 appliance. So let's get started. In this lab environment, we have all the vRealize Suite 2018 products, including the vRealize Suite Lifecycle Manager 2.1.0. In preparation for future upgrades of vRealize Suite 2018 products or deployment of the new vRealize Suite 2019, we need first in this environment to upgrade the existing LCM 2.1 to LCM 8.0, which is really a side-by-side migration, as you will see in this video. Let's take a look at the existing LCM environment 2.1 and what it consists of. So currently we have one appliance that's running LCM, which is the management LCM-01, and it's managing an environment for a vRealize environment that consists of VROps, LogInsight, VRB, and VRA, and we're associating also the VMware Identity Manager appliance as well. If we actually log into LCM 2.1 and look at the environments that we're managing, you'll see an environment called VMware Lab located in Toronto. And we're currently managing all four products, vRealize Automation 7.6, vRealize Business for Cloud 7.6, LogInsight 4.8, and vRealize Operations 7.5. We also have in user management an association with VMware Identity Manager, and we're basically pointing to management IDM-01 that will be migrating its management to LCM 8.0 through the migration. Now, before we start the migration, let's take care of some of the requirements I mentioned at the beginning of the video. We've already set aside a new host name, IP address, and a DNS record for the new LCM 8.0 appliance that the vRealize Easy Installer will be creating for us. Secondly, we need to make sure that the password for the built-in account SSH user on the existing VIDM appliance is not expired. And to do that, we will launch simply PuTTY and try to SSH to the IDM appliance. Log in with the SSH user. Use the default password. And you can see here, I was logged in right away. If this user happened to be expired or the password for that user happened to be expired, you'll be prompted right away to change the old password and set a new one. The third requirement that we mentioned is that we need to enable root access for SSH on the existing VIDM appliance. By default, it's disabled. So The KB that I mentioned and I've also outlined in the blog is knowledge base article 2047626. If we, what we need to do is while we are on the appliance testing the SSH user, what we can do is simply switch user to root. And then basically we'll edit the file /etc/ssh/d_config. As you can see, the permit root login is set to no. So we'll hit insert and change that to yes, and then simply save the file. Once the file is saved, we need to restart the SSHD service using /etc init /d/ssh/d restart. All right. And there you have it. So this basically allows us to enable the root access for SSH on the identity appliance. Then we'll see after that, we'll take care of downloading and making sure that the install and the upgrade binaries are set up. And at the end, also, we want to make sure that there's enough storage space after all that on the new LCM 8.0 appliance. Now that we satisfied the main requirements, we can start by running the vRealize Easy Installer. So we have downloaded the Easy Installer ISO file from VMware.com. We will mount the file so we can access its contents. And here we have a three-folder structure. The OVA folder contains the product binaries that will be copied to vRealize Suite Lifecycle Manager. And then the Easy Installer itself will actually use the OVF tool to deploy LCM from this OVA. And then the last folder is the actual UI installer, and you can install or launch the installer for Linux, Mac, or Windows. We're using Windows 10 here, so we will access the Win32 and find the installer.exe. So we'll double click. Once the vRealize Easy Installer is loaded, we will select the migrate option so we can migrate from an earlier version of vRealize Suite Lifecycle Manager. On the introduction page, there's a few really good points here that you should be aware of, that the versions from which direct migration is supported is three editions, 1.3, 2.0 and 2.1. If you have a version of LCM that is prior to 1.3, you will need to upgrade first to 1.3 or later before you actually can do the migration. Also, a few details about what kind of or type of data that will be migrated. So we're looking at migrating the data centers and the vCenter endpoints. All the existing environments, so in our situation or scenario, we will be looking to migrate the VMware lab environment that includes four vRealize products. All your DNS, SNMP, and NTP settings, including the credentials in the account for my VMware, and any proxy details that you have configured on LCM. In addition, the migration of the VIDM installation that is associated with the LCM existing instance that we're migrating from, and this is something that we're going to do here, and Blackstone content endpoints. Blackstone is an internal code name that was used to describe the content management endpoint that was included in LCM. And this is when you had the functionality of moving content from one environment to another, things like blueprints, and for example, in VRA, or management packs or dashboards from one environment to another. What you will not see migrating is the actual content. So if you had any content management that you've already captured, in the previous LCM instance that you have that you're migrating from, these contents will not migrate. So let's hit next. We'll accept the terms of the license agreement and whether you want to join the customer experience improvement program or not. We'll leave that up to you. You can click next. Right now, we're going to specify the destination vCenter that we will be deploying the new LCM 8.0 appliance to. So that's and that's the same vCenter that actually hosting the old instance. So we'll provide the password. We'll accept the certificate. We'll select the data center. I've actually created a folder specifically for vRealize Suite 2019, so I'm going to target to put all the appliances related to that, and also once they're upgraded. So starting with LCM, this will be the target folder where the VM is going to be, or where the appliance is going to be provisioned. Next, we will select the folder. Next, we will select the resource, which is the Toronto Management Cluster, where we're deploying the virtual appliances to. We'll hit next. We'll select our storage. We have more storage here. Of course, enable thin disk mode is enabled by default. We'll hit next. And for the network setting, here we're going to select the network that the appliance is going to be linked to. And all the network metadata in terms of what type of IP assignment. So we're doing static, or you can use DHCP. Subnet mask, the default gateway, the DNS server, the domain name, and also we are providing the or configuring the NTP server for the appliance OS itself. So we'll hit next. The password configuration, this is setting the password for all products. And for when it comes to LCM, that's the root password and the built-in admin password. And when it comes to Identity Manager, and this is if we were to deploy a new environment, a new instance of IDM, that'll be the password setting for admin and the SSH user. But also what we're doing here, we're setting the default configuration user, which we will not be creating during the migration. So let's set a password. All right, we'll hit next. Now we're going to specify all the LCM inputs. So in this case, we'll use the name that we set aside for the new LCM appliance. So that's management LCM-02. We're giving it this IP address, and we'll set its host name with the fully qualified domain. Hit next. All the migration detail of the old version of LCM from where the data is to be migrated. So this is the LCM instance that we showcased in the lab. Management LCM-01, and then we have the built-in admin localhost and the admin password and the root SSH password for the appliance. We'll hit next. I have the option here to install a net new VIDM, and this is where I can set my default configuration admin, which we set the password for. But in our case, we will be actually importing an existing VMware Identity Manager. The plan is that we will upgrade that later with LCM 8.0 before we can deploy VRA 8, since it's a requirement. On the import of VIDM, there's a few really important note here. First of all, the existing VIDM in the old version will be imported to a new version using the migration details. But what's been stated here is that VIDM should be in vRealize Suite Lifecycle Manager form factor. So what is a form factor? Anything that is not listed here in terms of how VDM is configured. So VIDM will not be in vRealize Suite Lifecycle Manager form factor if you have any of the below cases. The first case, if you have a single node with the latest version of VIDM, but you had connectivity to an external Postgres or SQL server. Or you have the latest version of VIDM 3.3.1, but this time, instead of a single node, you have a clustered and also a connection to an external Microsoft SQL database. The two presents like different configuration for VDM that you can set in your environment. Lastly, if your VIDM version is less than the latest, which is 3.3.1, which in our case 3.3.0, if you are a single or cluster setup and have an external database to Postgres or SQL, then again, you're not considered a form factor, or if you have a Windows or an external connectors. So the instance that we're trying to import is using really the built-in database. So it is actually a vRealize Suite Lifecycle Manager form factor VIDM. We'll hit next. Now that we have the summary, we'll review the setting before starting the appliance and simply hit submit. The installation process is, as you can see, is initializing. Once it's initialized, if we actually flip to the vCenter, you'll see that the OVF has already been deployed. We're targeting the vRealize Suite 2019, so we see your management. We see the management LCM-02 being deployed. So what we'll do, let's sit back and watch the process completes.
You're now listening to A-Rod Music.
The installation process is completed standing up vRealize Suite Lifecycle Manager, so all the services are up, but the migration is not yet completed. The migration request has been created successfully, and the Easy Installer went through initialization initially and standing up the LCM. Once the moving the binaries was completed, which really in my lab took the most time here, until we got to the initiating the migration itself, you're presented with two URLs. Both will take you to the vRealize Lifecycle Manager and get you to log in, but this one here will take us right to the migration request. And let's do that. We'll click on the link. We'll accept. All right. And then we'll log in with admin.local, and that's the built-in account in LCM 8.0. And the password is the password that we created during the installer, which is the shared password. Once we log in, you see we're taken right into the request, and of course we have an error, and this is expected. But before we get into and talk about this error, I want to show you that the migration actually has two requests. One is the creation of the global environment. This is the environment that will include VIDM, and then once the VIDM migration is successful, we go and create or do the second migration request, which is the one. So this migration request actually failed because the migration failed when creating the global environment. So the second request failed because the first request failed. So I just wanted to outline that. So let's go into the initial request. You want to focus on the global environment and look at the error. So if we actually look at the error, you'll see that the unable to verify the SSH user's password. So this is the default built-in SSH user that initially we made sure that the password isn't expired. Okay, so we know the password is okay and not expired. So let's show more here. You can see that we're actually logging in here with the SSH user into the existing VIDM environment. This is basically to be able to migrate VIDM into that global environment that we're creating in LCM 8.0. The reason this has failed, and if I actually go into the actual request and hit retry, you'll see I'm using here an SSH user password, and that's the VIDM admin password, which for some reason is not really successful. So if I actually submit this again, it will fail another time. So once it gets here, it'll fail, telling me the same message that the SSH user password, ensure the password is not already expired, and you know, etc. So what we want to do to fix this is create our own password. One of the new services in vRealize Suite Lifecycle Manager is the Locker service. And this is where we can create and store our certificates. So once the migration is actually kicked off and successful, we'll see all the certificate coming from the destination LCM, our licenses, and most importantly, the passwords. So one thing, this is all the passwords that was captured from the old LCM environment. I have two pages of like password. There's like 12 passwords here. So what we want to do, we want to create our own for the SSH user. So the password alias, which will be the password identifier, I'm going to just so I can recognize, this will be the SSH user password. And the password actually here, I'm going to type it in. This is the password we logged in when we were testing that the password is not expired. And the description really should be the same as the alias. So I'm going to copy that and paste it here. And the username now, this is where it's really, we have to mention the user account. So SSH user. So we've added our own password. So I'm going to add. Now I'm going to go back to the main menu by clicking on the banner here. Go to the lifecycle operations, go to requests, and hit failed here so I can retry the request on the global environment creation. Hit retry, and what I want to do here is drop down the menu and select the password that I just created, and that's the SSH user password, and hit submit. Let's see if we pass that error. Yeah, and look, we did pass the SSH user verification, but we hit another error. So let's take a look at what the error is. Before we actually hit retry, it says here that it failed to find the product in the specified vCenter, VMware Identity Manager instance with host name or IP management, not found for the given vCenter details. Now I did mention that the VIDM instance is actually exists in the vCenter that we configured or targeted to install LCM. But for some reason, it can't find it. So it can't find it. It failed to find the product in the vCenter. This could be a hostname mismatch, the IP address like not found for the given vCenter details. Really, I don't understand why would it not find the host name or the IP of the management. It's not in its database for some reason. So let's hit retry. And here we're going to provide the vCenter name. So, and this is, the username. And that would be the administrator. And this is the same username I used when I actually set the vCenter. retry for product vIDM. The vCenter host name, that would be management. VCS-01, fully qualified domain name, and the vCenter password. Now, again, if we actually select here, we'll see a lot of passwords. There is a lot for vCenter, so I'm going to select the vCenter management VCS-01 password here. And I'm going to hit submit. If we click back on the request, and see if we can pass that error. Should be around here. Okay, we passed it. All right, and we moved on to stage three. And that is the setting the authorization provider. So you can see things are actually moving along. All right, and that's completed. Now that the original request completed, you guys remember that this migration invoke request failed because initially the initial request failed when creating the global environment. And now that we fixed that, I can simply come in on this failed task and hit retry. There's no inputs required here, so we'll just click submit. It will know that the environment is created. We'll go to in progress and see if we hit any issues here. So it looks like the migration invoked. I see one stage here, but we'll see more once the first stage is completed. All right, you see that's completed. Let's refresh, hit request again. And we have two new environments. So the migration invoke request has been completed. Now we create two more requests. One is downloading the license from my VMware, and the other one is the VMware lab environment that we're now importing. So we successfully imported VIDM, but now we failed in migrating the VMware lab environment from the existing VIDM. So let's go ahead and check what's the error. So if we actually hit the explanation mark, it says VRA. So we're some problem with VRA import properties are either null or empty for some reason. So let's go ahead and actually click on the failed and see if there's anything that we can provide. So we're missing some VRA properties. Again, I don't know why these property would be missing. This is something we're internally looking into. So, but it's fixable. So let's go ahead and hit the primary node hostname for VRA, and that's the cafe appliance. That's the management VRA-01. I'm going to put the fully qualified domain here, vmwarelab.local. Now, for the primary node root password, there's a couple of things I've tried, and the only one that seems to work for me is the VMware Lab infra default password. But if you look here, you'll see there is like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 different password that was captured. And to be honest, it's really hard. The VMware lab represents the name of the environment that's coming in from the destination. And then you have VRA. This is all about VRA products. And then we have the name of the vCenter, and you can see 1, 2, 3, 4 different endpoints or passwords captured for this vCenter. When I actually checked the locker service, it seems that the administrator at vSphere.local is the same for all, is used for all these four. The only one that is different is this one here. So I'm going to give this a try. And instead of using the infra default, let's go ahead and use the VMware Lab VRA VC password right away. Now it's asking me for the VRA admin password. For me in this lab, the password for root and admin is the same. So I'm going to again use the VRA VC password. And the tenant username password is the same as well. So I'm going to again use the same VRA VC password. So and we'll hit submit and see if we actually pass. Now, one note I will say, if you are really don't know which password to select, just go ahead to the locker and create the known password that you know, give it a proper name, and then come back here and select them accordingly. So let's hit submit and see if we actually pass the error. So let's go in. It looks like we hit the error again. So that did not work. So again, we're failing on the VRA input environment. So what I'll do is I'll select a different account that I know worked in the past, and that's a different password that worked in the past, and that's the VMware Infra default password. So I'm going to select that for all of them and submit and see if that works. Okay, it's taking more time, did not fail right away, so that's a good sign. All right, you can see we passed the VRA import, which was here. So we passed, we're now at the end, stage three completely finished. So let's go to stage four. And now we're importing VROps, the VROps environment. That seems very straightforward. We didn't have any problem with the credentials. We seem just to hit a problem with the VRA credentials or properties, missing properties, which we fixed in the retry action. VROps is completed. We go to 5. We do an environment update. And then finally, we do an environment health schedule. And here you have it, like all 6 stages completed. So if we go back to the request, we still have, and they're all completed. So it looks like we have a successful migration. So let's go ahead and actually click on, if you remember in initial video, for the verifying the migration task, we needed first to make sure that the data center and the vCenter inputs are configured. So we can simply go to the data center. You can see my default data center, which is first the vCenter is added here. And then all my data centers. So in Toronto, I have vCenter, which is VCS. That's the default vCenter that was initially imported. That's the right region. We have Ottawa. That's another vCenter endpoint. And so it looks like all my vCenters came in, and my development environment, my third vCenter. So great. So this is looking good. If we look at the environments, we'll see the global environment that we initially migrated, and that includes the VIDM 3.3.0. All right. And then the VMware Lab, which includes the 4 products, 7.6. VRBC 7.6, Log Insight 4.8, and VROps 7.5. And also the health that's coming from the VROps instance is actually provided here. If we click on the details, just to show you that everything that came in, so we have all the products on the top. Right now I'm looking at VRA. I can add components, I can do upgrades. For vRealize for Business, the same thing. I can click on this and get all the common names and data about the product. Okay, so things look great. Now, one thing we need to do is very soon is upgrade VIDM. So if I actually go in and look at the details of VIDM, you'll see it's 3.3.0. Now, if I hit upgrade, I'm going to get an error. It's going to say no repositories found for this given version, which is 3.3.1. So one of the things that we need to do is basically configure in the settings our binary mappings. So in our binary mappings, you remember initially I said that there was an OVA folders and there was the product binaries for both VIDM and vRealize Automation, and that's exactly what we see here. These product binaries were copied to the LCM appliance and they're currently located locally or copied locally to the appliance. Now, what we need to do here is, and this is again something that we've mentioned in the requirements, is to download the install and upgrade binaries for all the new vRealize Suite 2019. And I did that already. So if I actually go to my NFS, go to my LCM repo, you will see that I have the Identity Manager 3.3 pack, upgrade pack. I have the Log Insight upgrade pack and also the full OVA for Log Insight 8.0. I have the update pack for vRealize operations. Yes, it's a single pack right now that you can use the upgrade from 7.5 to 8.0 instead of using two different packs. That's a great enhancement and easier management. And then also I have the full 8.0 OVA. So everything here I have in my NFS. So all I have to do is add those binary to the LCM 8.0. So my location type is actually an NFS. I will type the base location for the NFS share where I have downloaded the install and the upgrade binaries for vRealize Suite 2019. And I'll hit discover. Once I hit discover, I'm gonna select all of them. And this will be, and those will be added to my product binary so I can execute on my upgrades or new deployments of any of the vRealize 2019 products. So let's add them. We can click to check the request status. As you can see, the request is completed. So if we go back to binary mappings, we have all the product binaries available for us, the install and all the upgrades. So now if we actually go in and go to the environment, and if we tried, for example, to upgrade, which we will do in a separate video, you can see I don't get the error anymore since the repository for the vRealize Suite repository includes the upgrade binaries for 3.3.1. The same thing applies if I actually go and click in any of those except VRA. If I actually click VRA, you can't, if I say upgrade, it'll say no versions are available because it's not an implicit upgrade. But if I do go to any of the other tools like VROps, for example, and hit upgrade, you can see I can again since I have the binaries, I can execute on the upgrade. So let's go back. Last thing I want to mention in terms of the requirements is making sure that we still have enough storage on the new LCM after everything we did, from migrations to uploading the install and upgrade binaries. So if we go to settings and system details, and you'll see we're at 88%. So what we can do here right away, what LCM allows us to do, is extend the storage. So we'll get extend storage. We'll specify the host name for the vCenter where the appliance is running. Fully qualified domain name. I'm gonna use the vCenter credentials, and this would be this one here, VCS01. That's where I'm connecting to. And the disk size in gigabytes. So I think I already have 20, so we wanna add 80 so we can make it 100 gig. So, and I'm gonna simply say extend. Again, the request successfully submitted. We do have total storage of 20 gig, so we should have 100, almost close to 100 gig after the request. So if we click here to check on the request, all right, so the request is completed. If we go back to settings, system details, and you can see that the total storage now is 99 gig, and we're at 18% storage used, which is very optimal. With that, this concludes the video. Thank you for watching.